During his long, great career, Mo only ever made one film. But there was a reason why. And here is his widow, Sadie, to tell us why.
He was broken-hearted. When we went out that night to see that picture, he just shook his head at me when we came out. He said, "Mum," he said, "that's the finish of it." He said, "They've sliced it to pieces," he said, "and they've left the best stuff on the cutting room floor." Because he used to tell me, when he came home at night, he'd say, "Oh, did a funny scene today," and he'd tell me, and half these scenes were cut out. It was a bitter disappointment to him. It was very badly cut in the finish, and he's always resentful that he made that film.
Here is Mo trying to recite The Village Blacksmith while I heckle him.
"Today, in response to numerous requests, I'm going to recite to you my own original poem, The Village Blacksmith, by Longfellow. The Village Blacksmith."
"Aye, which village?"
"Oh, blimey, that mug's in again."
"I asked you which village?"
It's a little English village, Ashby de la Zeus by the sea. "The village blacksmith, under the spreading chestnut tree, the village smithy stands."
"Why? Why did he stand?"
"Because his anvil was too hot to sit down." "Now listen, a boy can be a fair go. That's all I ask is a fair go. The village blacksmith, under the spreading chestnut tree, the village smithy stands. The smith and mighty man was here with large and sinewy hands."
"Why were his hands sinewy?"
"Oh, blimey, listen. You try picking up red hot horseshoes and see what your hands are." "The smith, the mighty man, was here with large and sinewy hands, and the muscles of his brawny arms stood out like iron bands. Verse two."
"Just a minute. You haven't told us what his name was."
"His name was Smith. Rastus Smith."
"Rasta Smith?"
"Yes, he was a blacksmith." "Put that on your bellows and blow it." "Verse two. His hair was crisp and black along. His face was like the tan." "Oh, dear, look. Look. I don't think I'd better say the next line. I hate anything coarse."
"Go on. What is it?"
"His brow was wet with honest perspiration."
Aye, sweat.
"It was too." "With perspiration. But to continue, he looks the old world in the face and owes not any man. So far, so good. Verse three. The children hurrying home from school."
"What school?"
"Well, if you must know, it was my old school."
"Your old school?"
"Yes, St. Patrick's."
"St. Patrick's?"
"Yes, and do you want to make something of it, Mug?" "The children hurrying home from school."
"Oh, pull your ears.
Oh, listen, old boy, I wish you'd stop interrupting and let the kids get home from school."
"Oh, yeah, well, why are they in such a hurry?"
"They want to get to the village before the pub closes." "The children hurry home from school looking at the open door."
"Yeah, what do they see through the open door?"
"The beer's on."
"Listen, what are you talking about? They weren't looking in the pub door. It was a blacksmith shop."
"I was just coming to that. They love to see the flaming forge."
"Which flaming forge?"
"Oh, any flaming forge." "Oh, Santa Claus, I'm getting nowhere here, Queen Eye." "They love to see the flaming forge and hear the bellows roar."
"What makes the bellows roar?"
"Oh, strike me lucky. Wouldn't you roar if you had your snowman stuck in red hot coal?" "Look, I know what I'm talking about, really." "Oh, yes. They catch the burning sparks that fly like chaff from a threshing floor."
"What does all that mean?"
"Well, I'll explain it. Although it's really very, very simple, it means that the children love to catch the burning flies." "Oh, I'm sorry. I mean the sparks. They used to catch these sparks, put them in bottles, and sell them as glowworms."
"Aye. What was the blacksmith doing all this time?"
"He was sitting on his anvil, picking his teeth with a red-hot nail."
"This fork."
puzzle. What did the village blacksmith have to do with a green-eyed yellow idol?
Quite a lot.
He married her.
Ah!
That's fun!
Well, make sure it's the right bird.
Verse 4. It's a very, very sad bird.
Yeah, it can't be any worse than the others, but let's hear it.
It's all about the blacksmith's son, Little Willie. Little Willie, in the best of sashes, fell in the fire, was burned to ashes. Soon the forge grew cold and chilly because his daddy couldn't stir up Willie.
Hey, Longfella never wrote that.
No, but he would have if I hadn't thought of it first.
Bertha!
Isn't this sickening? Verse 5. The smith was shy and slow of speech. He was impeded by a stammer. To one great day's language flow.
Why?
He hit his thumb with a flaming hammer.